Okay. A little short of breath here. But I'm going to try to explain this sign. I'm not sure if I'm being focused or not, having to do all this by myself. I have yet to find anyone willing to concur with me on anything. So, probably the lonely guy in the world. But I can't help but be amazed at my own effort anyway. How, with each and every day, I seem to be getting better and better by leaps and bounds. To the point that I have someone concurring with me after all. It's a creepy thought, I'm still atheist, but I'll come to the conclusion if God helped those who help themselves, it's to be right. I mean, that's not in the Bible, or it argued that whether it is or not. This is something that just contributed mostly to Benjamin Franklin and the poor Richard Almanac, but it even goes back before him. God help those who help themselves. So I decided that the secret was in the pronoun. The bigger the larger the themselves is, the pronoun, the more likely God should be on that person's side, if indeed there is one of them. I like to think of the neighborhood that I live in be extending halfway around the world in all four directions to the same point in the Indian Ocean. The opposite end of the earth from where you're at right now. The antipolar point, the whole continental U.S. would be flooded in the Indian Ocean. I find that kind of interesting considering that the Indians were here first. Well, the different, they're not the original Indians that Marco Polo was looking for. Well, okay, this sign had the top USA and the bottom ISIS. Now, this is my way of trying to explain. If we are going to continue believing in a God the way we are currently doing it now in our part of the world, half of the world, then I have no choice but accepting the rights of those halfway around the world from here, believing in a God however way they feel it necessary for them needing to believe in a God, including 72 virgins waiting for 19 dead pilots soon to be arriving. Again, I'm atheist, but I'm only trying to find a way crossing the bridge without people of faith. I've come to the conclusion that I will never be able to prove to people of faith that there is no God while I'm alive, or anyone for that matter, nor will they be able to prove to me that there is a God until they kill me. Well, that's too late, and I don't like the idea of having to wait for y'all to catch up to pay you back. And plus, if you're all means all, you're not going to find what's waiting for you to be a picnic if I leave the planet prematurely because of lack of effort from your part. You're not going to find it to be a picnic when you catch up with me. So I've taken two songs. At the top it says, it's all the same, only the name will change. That comes from a song by Bon Jovi, Wanted Dead or Alive. It's all the same, only the names will change, but from Bon Jovi the group, the song Wanted Dead or Alive. Well, at the bottom I got, all I know is that to me it looks like you're having fun. That's a song from a group, Dead or Alive, a British pop group, Dead or Alive. And the name of the song is Spin Me Around Like a Record. Again, all I know is that to me, it looks like you're having fun. Some. We have this defensive attitude here about our wealth. We work hard on money and try to keep it, but that creates a gradient. And halfway around the world, we got people that are dependent, whose economy is dependent on that, yet they are living right on the edge, the margin, make or break, and it's very tough. I mean, and I can understand now why women are treated the way they are. If you allow women to have the freedom, that will be competing with men for jobs. And again, I'm not saying I like this, but we have got to stay out of it and let them decide what's best for them. Same as we expect others to stay out of our business. So we have no business being over there. We're interfering. So again, you got east, west, spinning around. It's all the same, only the names will change. But you also got culture-wise, all I know is that to me, it looks like you're having fun, and we got God competing against each other. Well, I do not believe in a God. I'm not saying there isn't a God, but I do not believe, I choose not to believe in one. I simply mean that I choose to believe in zero God as opposed to no God. Zero compared to one, they're both national numbers, they're both real numbers. It's not one of the counting numbers. So where does our count and where do we stop? I truly believe that children never really grow up until the parent died. And if God really did it, he would want us to pretend that he is dead and be in charge of our own fate without any reward or punishment. We can't do it here, and why would he, reward us there? So this is just my attempt at being an amateur atheist philosopher. Another sign that I made. I am on everyone's side, ... but only up to a point, ... Proverbs 16:1. Well, this is not what Proverbs 16:1 says. This is what I decided it's trying to say. Based on my experience, is how I interpret it. What it really says is something more like the plans of heart belong to men. I'm going to change that to the plans of heart may belong to men. But the answer from the tongue is from the Lord. My God, why have you forsaken me? That to me would be an example of the answer of the Lord, of the tongue being from the Lord. Or a blue jay. One day I was sitting on the patio, smoking from the crack pipe. The nice thing about smoking from a crack pipe, well, there's nothing nice about the crack part. But you can think both inhaling and exhaling. And when I'm all alone in the house with my crack pipe, I got nothing better to do but to think. Well, I don't like most, the average typical gay man. I don't think about sex. It seems to turn most of them into 24-hour raging sex machine. I had already had so much sex by the time I got exposed to crystal meth that it turned me off from sex and made me chatty. I like talking. I like sharing my opinion. And sharing my opinion is only my way of giving you the chance of being confrontational, offensive, giving you the chance to be offended, confrontational back at me. And if you can't defend your position against my position, then only you know how best to take care of the problem. And I can't find it in you than how the churches are all taken out with restraining orders and criminal trespassing. They cannot, argue. They have no good point to argue with the point. I'm getting so good at this, but they don't know. Well, you saw me wearing the Mickey Mouse ears, right? Let me put them on now. I came across this picture online of Jesus, the Sermon on the Mount, and he's got two different groups, dark and light. I'm assuming this is the people who love the life will lose it, and love or hate the life will have a fall eternity. I don't know. But he's wearing the Mickey Mouse, somebody photoshopped it. So, while loving only those who love you, what should remain in positive view? Should Should the law of the physics still hold true? Well, this is my, you know, the way I look at it. I did that once, you know. I stood up by the mailbox with my battery powered bubble gun, the blowing bubbles with a battery powered gun. A girl comes one finally picked her head out of the car. It was backed up with hard memory. There was an older man, well, not that old, but there was a woman in the passenger side. But he took his head out and goes, I like the ears. I was wearing the ears. And I go, and I said the same thing. If the law of the physics will still hold true, what should remaining positive do while loving only those who love you? Who be the leader of the club that the votes have been made for both you and me? Who be the leader of the club? And he's looking at me. And finally I go, eventually you're going to attract negative attention, like me. We have got to have a healthy balance of negatives along with our positive. And he starts to argue with me on that, and I cut him off and go, you are going to have to start accepting your fair share of negativity, or you're only going to continue attracting more 9/11 for all of us. And this, he didn't like hearing this, and he pulled back within the shadow of his car, and with an index finger, he rolled back up that power darkened window. Now, how in the hell am my goddamn little pinky going to be able to compete it up against all that higher power behind the index finger rolling up the darkened window? You'd be surprised. I mean, I'm being weird, crazy out here. I'm studying. I'm being very observant. And I can't help but notice how many cars have darkened windows. How many of them wait till they get up within sight of me to roll up the window? How many people seem to be on their cell phone faking it, even putting on makeup as if they're purposely trying to ignore me, piss me off? And I can't help but find it funny because I'm learning from it and extrapolating off of it. So there's nothing you can do. I'm a veterinarian. You know, you don't run a test unless the result can change anything. It will tell you something. Otherwise, you're just wasting a good test. Or you don't know what you're doing and the clients don't know it either. So, okay, I'm on everybody's side, but only up to a point. Now, there's Mickey Mouse, Jesus, Sermon on the Mount. There's me with my Mickey Mouse here, that Christ and the Antichrist. I said that to Reverend Dr. Beth, that was Janet Gary, wife of nationally known pastor, George Robert Gary Sr., Dr. Theology, who used to live in the house across the street. Janet, are you aware before there can be an Antichrist, there must first be a Christ? Well, I'm an Antichrist. Well, that was just my way, that was a different way of saying I'm an atheist. She already knew that. But, you know, so far, it's been 5 years later, almost 5 years later, and I still have not found one person willing to concur with me, agree with me on this. It's so simple, I can't imagine anybody not knowing this. But before we can have the word Antichrist, we must first have the word Christ. Well, in the Old Testament, we had a Christ, a desire, a hope, a dream. And Jesus was knowledgeable of his Old Testament. So in the way I look at it, if he was not claiming to be God, then that actually makes him the first Antichrist. He was not claiming to be God. I am on everybody's side, but only up to a point. Once he's gone, there's no more he can do. I mean, we can do what we want with him. They can't speak with themselves at all. I mean, the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. All they can do is scream when we catch them and torture them like at Jerry Kermit Center. Jesus is wearing the orange like at Guantanamo Bay. So we're not excluded from this. So we've got old people. We don't need universal health care. Why? They get it for free. Well, then why have insurance? Lose it! I can understand why people think I'm bipolar, but it's not bipolar for good reason. This is Reverend Josh Emerson and Reverend Blair Custis, I don't know, whatever. They were both at Glen Memorial and I met the church on Emory Campus, but he moved on somewhere else. I can't help but wonder if it had something to do with the meeting with me. And it's beginning to rain, so I'm going to turn this off and run back inside.
Maybe God is crying.